Fly Guy, we continue on with their Marvel Legends 6-inch SPDR Build-A-Figure Wave of reviews. This is just over 6 inches tall, and this is Cloak from Cloak and Dagger. I was going to say Cloak and Dagger, but she's a separate figure. So we get a very nice box art on there. Without a doubt, it's definitely John Tyler Christopher doing that. Stonking picture of Dagger there. Looks really good. Great pose. Little wrinkles in the sculpt. God, very cool. He needs to do the vintage card art. He's way better at this. And of course, Dagger in the background there. So they share a box. Cloak and Dagger share the box. Nice shiny logo as usual on there. Like that. I've never seen that logo before. CD up at the top for Cloak and Dagger. Never seen that. Very cool. It's a good TV show. I've only 2 episodes in, but it's actually pretty damn good. So, and the logo in the back of the box too, you can just see it there. On the back of the box, you get a glam shot of the two. Again, they share the same case, so each one looks exactly the same. A hooded vigilante in the war on drug crimes, Tyrone Johnson uses powers of darkness as Cloak. Maybe there is a separate box for her. Okay, we'll get a look at that shortly. Anyway, SPDR is the Build-A-Figure, as we said. All of these figures, make them check out the channel, just click subscribe and you'll get to see all of them. Press the little bell and you'll get a notification as soon as I've got it ready. Looking pretty good though. Again, pick this up at Darkside Toys, just very fast shipping. Check them out in the link in the description below. For those that don't want to do that, there's a UPC for you. But do like it. Now, this is an interesting figure. It is a really good looking figure. It's very dark, so it's going to be a little bit hard to see. But the cape is stunning. I'm going to take this figure apart because it's a little bit hard to look at and review. But it stands beautifully because of the cape. It is a very black figure. Not only is the cape and the figure itself black, but hooded is a little bit hard to see. So again, I'm going to take it apart. But first of all, let's pop the head off so we can get in there and have a look. And what we notice underneath is, as I said, it's a jet black, completely solid black body. There is nothing really on this at all. There's no paint. The only thing that is different is, kind of like the Fantastic Four, we've got a translucent hand. If you can just about see that, maybe see it against them. No, that's really hard to see. It's not full translucent, like Sue Storm, I should say. But it's there. So you've got translucent fingers, essentially, because the hand's so solid. So you've got a different type of plastic on most of the body, but down at the hands, it's a different kind of plastic. So there we go. There's this other hand, is this light plastic too. So, yes. Very clear. And that is it. Nothing else on the body. It's all just one solid body. There's nothing else to it, no paint, no weathering, nothing. It's a kind of purpley kind of black. It's kind of weird. More purple, I would say, than black, but the camera's probably not picking that up. Standard stuff, though, peck holes. And let me get a look at the articulation first. So you can see the ball joint without an issue there. And again, there's nothing to kind of stop this or hinder this movement, but he is wearing the cape, so you can't really do this. Ball joint with the hinge up at the top there, swivel at the bicep, double joints at the elbows. You've got swivel wrists back and forth. You've got a pretty reasonable ab crunch. Again, you just can't get to use all this. You've got a swivel waist. You get pegs up at the top, thigh swivel, double joints at the knees all the way down. You get a boot cut, and you get rocking ankles, all this articulation, and you can't use it. So how frustrating is that? So there's the body. We'll put that to the side for 1 second. But the start of the show was this cape. I mean, this is what he's all about, or the cloak, I should say. It's a kind of translucent-ish plastic. You can see that a little bit there as I shine the light on it. Maybe if I position the light a different way. No, it doesn't really show it, but it is translucent. You can see a little bit down at the bottom down here. So there's my finger right. Yep, you can see the translucency. So it's a very nice kind of weird material. Then on the outside here, very well sculpted. It flows beautifully. It looks good. It sits on them well. The back, you get some really nice kind of folds and sculpts as it comes down from the neck. It's just really nice. Again, this is the central point about this figure. Now, the head is glued onto the top of the cloak, so you can't remove it. It's basically kind of, it's glued on. And what it looks to be, like there's a piece, I don't know if you can kind of see that. It's so hard to see. You have to take my word for it. There's a piece of plastic up at the top of the hood, and then the hood's got a kind of groove that it kind of clicks into and then is glued. So it's not as if you can take it away. If you did take it away, you literally would have a huge hole in his head. So that's the only way you get to display it, which is really not great, actually. I would have loved to take these. You can just see it up there. You see that? Maybe just... anyway. So what we do get on his face, it's hard to see, is some kind of purpley shading, which is beautifully done. A very nice styled beard, lots of kind of detail on it, and silver eyes, and detail on his forehead, wrinkles and eyebrows. It's a very cool looking figure that way. And again, the translucent aspect adds a little creepy, transporting-y kind of effect to it, I guess. So you have to kind of put it all together. The buckle is quite nice, I should mention, on this figure too, which actually unhooks, so you can take it off if you wanted to, but of course the plastic's just going to come right back, so it's kind of not really possible. Anyway, pop it back on, pop the head up through there, it pops out, and again pop the head on the top of the figure, and what you do get is a very cool looking figure. He just has a kind of really cool style about him. And again, very hard to review and show you, but it is going to be a figure that you're not really going to pose in many action poses too much because of this cape. It's going to hinder you. So you're going to have him standing upright and literally a hand out or a hand underneath. That's about as big as your whack you're going to get. But, you know, that's the way it goes. Maybe in this case, a fabric cape would have been the way to go, but cost-wise for Hasbro, that's probably a lot of money for them for this wave. But I don't know. Let me know what you think of Cloak. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this figure because of the unusual and the limitations on him. Anyway, again, if you want to pick this up, link underneath. Go get it at Darkside. Let me know what you think of the figure. And if you're brand new to the channel, I'm sure you know this drill by now. Click subscribe, click the bell. You'll get lots of reviews straight into your inbox. We'll see you for the rest of the figures in this wave coming right up.